On YouTube, Astronaut Bear here. Saw a comment on a video I just posted up, and you know, people, some of you guys have messaged me and want me to, you know, make a little room tour. Please excuse us because it's being shot on a camera phone. No professional equipment here. It's just my collection, and it's a Monday morning. Here we go. Thought, you know, before I head out to the gym, I'm gonna show you guys my collection. All right, so let's do this tour. All right, let's follow me. Let's go. Here, you know, Joker PF and the Harley Quinn. This is a custom Joker. Got the pistol. There's a lot of switch outs that I have for this Joker. If you notice, that is the regular portrait but with a hat on, custom made. And I have obviously the regular head without the hat. I absolutely hated the exclusive portrait with the hat on this Joker, so I don't have that one. And then I have the new 52, you know, basically the skin mask that he wears. I have that portrait too, by Mad-X. So definitely a grail right here in my collection. Love this Joker. Beautiful premium format. If you see back here, the Killing Joke, he's got the hat on. And then I got Harley Quinn back there as well. Beautiful pieces. Down here, Batgirl. She's one of my favorites. You know, I didn't grow up on Batgirl. And as I've grown older, I've become a fan of this character. Beautiful piece. You know, I think this is best female piece that came out last year, in my opinion. So. Down here, two gorgeous premium formats that are just so underrated. And Sideshow really dropped the ball here by not continuing this line. In my opinion, that Cobra Commander is still the best premium format statue made. When it, you know, mixed media, flawless execution on these statues. You know, sadly they're just underrated, but I think it's a character thing, you know. Plus they didn't finish the line, which sucks. I would have gone for the entire line. Next to them, got the both variants. Exclusive Harley Quinn. Poison Ivy. I think with this original, there's no way it's X or fail. I mean, the regular is just garbage with the bulbs, you know. You gotta have the man-eating plant. Personally, between these two, I like the flesh tone more. That's not to say that this one isn't beautiful. They're both gorgeous, and there's a reason why I have both. Above them, the beautiful Catwoman. Again, both statues are gorgeous. Love having both of them. I will say I love this base much more than that one. You know, it's fitting though. Beautiful face on her, beautiful colors, just beautifully done. And then we move up here, Batman himself, probably one of the greatest PFs ever made. Jim Lee portrait. This is one that won't leave my collection. I love it too much. Up there, got a 1/3 scale Hollywood Collectibles Group Wolverine. Massive, massive statue up there. He's fucking heavy, and he's pretty solid too. I think he's fully solid. There's no hollowness in that thing. He's just massive. Custom commissioned Batgirl art cover there. I know people have asked me on Facebook, hey, where'd you get that? It's a custom commission. Spider-Man collection up here. Move over here. You got Punisher Comiquette. Fan favorite here. One of the best Comiquettes ever made. I think my favorite part of this whole statue is that pistol holstered in there. I just love all the details that they did on this. Custom Wolverine. Look at that. Look at that blood. Boom. Love this. Love this. Just gorgeous. Big daddy of them, Lobo. This was a statue that I had on pre-order long before the hype. You know, a lot of people buying this statue don't even know who the fuck the character is, but whatever, you know. I'm a character collector myself. I go after these characters that I grew up on. And lots of great statues out there, but you gotta pick and choose, and I will not waste my time on a character I don't know. Perfect execution. My opinion, this is statue of the year. There's no competition. 2015, this is the statue of the year. When you look at the details that are put in this, especially mixed media, you cannot compare. The amount of pieces that came with this, the amount of attention to detail, yeah. This is statue of the year, in my opinion. All right, Gambit and Rogue. Two of my favorite X-Men's. I mean, not much more to say right here. Boom, gotta get that money shot right there. Love them, beautiful. As much as I love these two premium formats, I think it's Sideshow's turn now to remake these characters. Just give us new modern premium formats. These are the OGs, we need new ones. But gotta keep it Jim Lee style. Gotta keep it Jim Lee. All right, Emma Frost, sexy. And then you got Deadpool, X-Force, which is my favorite. I've said this before when I did the review on this X-Force version, I like this X-Force much more than the red version. Just the shading, everything about this, even the base looks better, but you know. And then down here, both Black Widows. This to me is still the best female face sculpt Sideshow has done, and arguably best female statue face I've ever seen. Love her. I love the variants. I got both comic covers, as you've seen the back for this, where the inspiration came for the statues off that cover. So I got both, and her wearing the white suit and the black. Personally, me, I like the black suit. But I had to have both because I love this statue, and with the white one, it's an edition size of only 200. So if you find this, go get it, because it's definitely a beautiful statue. Over next to her, Hawkeye, another underrated piece. This piece is really, really gorgeous. Light mixed media, but done perfectly. The boots, perfect. Just everything about it, it's just awesome. Up here, move to the Miss Marvels. This is the only XM piece I own, which is fine because not really interested in the other ones. But definitely great XM piece, beautifully done. I'm also character biased. I love Miss Marvel, so had to have it. Right here, Wolverine. This is the definitive Wolverine for me. I don't believe any other Wolverine will ever come close to this in posture, stance, execution.
beautiful Eric Sosa piece. Yeah, I mean, it's beautiful. Just very, very lucky to be able to have this in my collection. Storm, arguably, for me, guys, out of all the Sideshow X-Men pieces, this is the best X-Men statue they made. Underrated because not a fan favorite character, I understand that, but no doubt best X-Men piece. Everything from the base, the details on the base, the details of the statue, this is a winner for me. All right, and these two, they got to go together right here. Boom. Jean Grey and Cyclops, two great pieces. Not much more to say about them, just awesome pieces. And her hair is just huge. That thing is bigger than my hand. Doom! Favorite villain, Doom. Guys, I love this piece so much. I really do. It took me a long time to sculpt that cape like that. Do not be lazy with your fucking capes, guys. Do not be lazy with the capes. Sculpt that shit, alright? That's why it's got wires in it. Got my little display of Spider-Man awesomeness. I'm a huge J. Scott Campbell fan, so got to have these. This is waiting. I'm waiting for the Black Cat to come out, so I'll, you know, got the comic book ready. Those in the back are both signed, edition size of 50 and 100 with the gold pen by, that one's gold pen, that one's white, from J. Scott Campbell. These are gorgeous pieces. Love the scale too. The 1/5 scale is not bad. Love it. This is a 1/6 custom that was done. Dave Lesko painted for me and did it for me. I personally love this. Kind of downsizing, so it is up for sale, but definitely a beautiful little custom. So, and then up here, I got the more Miss Marvel stuff because I'm a big fan. Got Warbird costume and the classic. Love that Bowen took this straight out of the comic book. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Love it. I love this. So that's what Bowen did right. Took the comic book and made them. And we appreciate that with what Bowen did with his statues. Alright, so over here, I got an Edward Kenway statue by McFarlane. I'm a huge fan of the Black Flag game, and to me, the best Assassin's Creed game ever made. And this is just a beautiful statue, number 6 out of 950. He's surrounded by, you know, Captain Morgan Rum, and some Kraken back there. These two beauties, Kotobukiya Bishoujo, guard my good liquor. And that's about it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the little tour of my awesomeness. Did I forget about? Oh, I must have forgotten about the Hulks. So these Hulks right in the middle. This Comiquette right here is just amazing. Amazing. Love it. How do you pass on this thing? I can't believe when I see this being sold so cheap too. I'm like, what the fuck? Probably one of the coolest fucking Hulks ever created. Everybody's making a Hulk. Everybody. Yeah, you see a new fucking Hulk, but nothing compares to the awesomeness of this statue. Look at this. Look how massive this thing is. Look at that. Look. You see how massive that is? That's fucking huge. I have big hands, guys. All right, I'm a big dude. And this guy, fuck yeah, look at him. Alright, and I think I did forget one more statue. The Sentinel. Yep, there's a little Wolverine right there. This is the Sentinel statue.